Scientists have found that a thick layer of diamonds may exist hundreds of miles beneath Mercury's surface.
The James Webb Telescope has just shown us something shocking about Mercury, and it is truly terrifying. This tiny, scorching planet has been keeping its biggest hidden things for years. Recent images reveal strange, shiny spots that look like diamonds, and that's only the beginning. What is the core of Mercury made of? We will explore what else this strange world is hiding, that it is a direct threat to the human race. Mercury's hidden world comes to light. Mercury, the smallest planet in our solar system, has always caught the attention of those who love space and the stars. This tiny planet, hidden from view for a long time, began to share its details with us only when we got better at space travel. The quest to understand what Mercury is really like began with NASA's Mariner 10 mission back in 1973, and it grew with the launch of the Messenger probe in 2004. Before we go any further, it's clear that what's hidden on Mercury is far more unsettling than anyone expected, and this revelation is just the beginning of what will truly astound you. Mariner 10 was the first ever spacecraft to pay Mercury a visit, and it showed us what this hidden world really looks like up close. During its flights past the planet, it took pictures that displayed a landscape filled with craters and strange, moon-like ridges. This mission told us that Mercury is not just a ball of rock, it's a rough, crater-filled place with a surprisingly strong magnetic field and a core bigger than we thought. This was a big surprise because it challenged what scientists had previously thought about what Mercury was made of. 31 years after Mariner 10, we sent another mission called Messenger, which stands for Mercury Surface, Space Environment, Geochemistry, and Ranging. This mission took our understanding of Mercury to a whole new level. Unlike Mariner 10, Messenger was designed to actually orbit Mercury, which allowed us to study the planet in much more detail. During its mission, Messenger snapped a whopping 200,000 photos, showing us parts of Mercury we had never seen before. One of the coolest things Messenger found was the high levels of calcium and magnesium on the darker side of Mercury. This made scientists wonder about the processes that could cause such high concentrations. Also, the mission discovered that Mercury's magnetic field was really strong in the northern parts of the planet, which was not what we expected when compared to other planets. These findings made scientists rethink how Mercury came to be and what's going on inside it. Usually, on planets like Earth, magnetic fields are made by the movement of liquid iron in the core. But Mercury is different. Its unique inner structure causes its magnetic behavior to be different too. But there's more to Mercury than just craters and ridges. The extreme conditions on its surface are truly something else. During the day, temperatures on Mercury can soar to 430 degrees Celsius, 806 degrees Fahrenheit, hot enough to melt lead. At night, they can drop to a freezing negative 180 degrees Celsius, negative 292 degrees Fahrenheit. These crazy temperature swings are because Mercury has a very thin exosphere, which doesn't do much to keep the temperature steady or hold on to heat. Even with these tough conditions, recent research has found some surprising things on Mercury's surface. For instance, in 2012, data from Messenger showed signs of volcanic activity, including what looked like remains from explosive volcanoes. This was a shock because we used to think Mercury was geologically dead. What's more, in 2020, scientists announced they had found water ice in some of Mercury's craters near the poles. These spots are always in the shade, keeping them cold enough to hold onto ice, even though the planet is really close to the sun. This discovery has led to new questions about whether simple life forms could exist on Mercury, perhaps similar to the extremophiles we find in Earth's harshest places. The most recent trip to Mercury, called BepiColombo, was launched in 2018 by the European Space Agency and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. It's supposed to get there in 2025. This mission aims to give us even more detailed info about Mercury's surface, like what it's made of and its geological history. From its intense magnetic field to the surprise of finding water ice, Mercury keeps on giving us new surprises. But what we're about to find out next is really mind-boggling. How can a planet so close to the sun have a year that's shorter than its day? After learning about Mercury's surprising surface, we move on to its unusual spin and orbit. There's more to discover about this planet's movements. The unusual ways Mercury moves. When we think about planets, we usually picture them spinning once a day and orbiting the sun once a year. But Mercury doesn't follow this rule, and it's pretty wild. On this small super-hot planet, a year is actually shorter than a day. Here's the deal. Mercury goes around the Sun in just 88 Earth days. That's a super-fast trip, making a year on Mercury much shorter than our year. But here's the kicker. One full day on Mercury, one whole spin on its axis, takes a massive 176 Earth days. This means that on Mercury, a year lasts only half as long as a day. This weird setup leads to some bizarre sights. If you were standing on Mercury, you'd see the Sun rise and then slowly get bigger as it moves across the sky. Then at some point, the Sun would seem to stop, reverse a bit, and then start moving forward again. This strange motion happens because Mercury's spin can't keep up with how fast it's orbiting the Sun. But why does Mercury spin so slowly? Scientists think it's because of something called tidal locking. Over billions of years, the Sun's gravity has slowed down Mercury's spin. However, Mercury isn't completely tidally locked to the Sun like our Moon is to Earth. Instead, Mercury has a 3.2 spin orbit resonance, which means it spins three times for every two orbits it makes around the Sun. This unique day-night cycle leads to some of the most extreme weather you can imagine. One side of Mercury gets baked by the Sun for months, while the other side stays in total darkness and cold for just as long. This creates the wildest temperature changes in the solar system. Speaking of Mercury's atmosphere, it's pretty much non-existent, but what little there is called an exosphere. This super thin layer of gases is always leaking into space and being topped up by various things like the solar wind, radioactive decay, and even tiny impacts from space rocks. Recent studies using data from the Messenger spacecraft in 2020 have shown that Mercury's exosphere has more water vapor than we used to think. This water vapor is likely created when hydrogen from the solar wind reacts with oxygen in the rocks on Mercury's surface. Mercury, the tiniest planet in our solar system, never ceases to amaze scientists with its host of unique characteristics. Despite its compact size, this little planet has some seriously surprising features, and understanding them helps us learn not just about Mercury, but about other planets too, including our own. One of the most interesting things about Mercury is its magnetic field. Usually, when we think of magnetic fields around planets, we expect them to come from larger, faster spinning planets. But Mercury, despite being small and rotating slowly, has its own magnetic field. This was a big surprise when scientists first discovered it. The reason behind this magnetic field is Mercury's core, which is made of liquid metal. Even though it's small, the core is active, creating a magnetic field through a process called the dynamo effect. This effect happens because of the way Mercury moves and spins in space. This magnetic field is quite weak compared to Earth's, but it's critical for Mercury. It acts like a shield, protecting the planet from the solar wind. Solar wind is a stream of charged particles from the Sun that can strip away a planet's atmosphere. Without its magnetic field, Mercury's thin atmosphere would be blown away even faster by these solar winds. Now let's talk about how Mercury moves. It orbits the Sun really quickly, but spins on its axis very slowly. This unique combination leads to some extreme conditions on the planet's surface. For example, at certain spots on Mercury, you would see the Sun stop moving in the sky at certain times. These spots are known as hot poles because they get extremely hot. On the other hand, there are places near Mercury's poles that never see sunlight. These areas are in constant shadow and are incredibly cold. This contrast is fascinating and offers scientists valuable clues about the planet. Understanding Mercury's strange day and night cycle, we now look at the icy spots that change what we know about this hot planet. Ice in the hottest place. In these shadowy areas, scientists have made an exciting discovery. Ice. Yes, there's ice on Mercury. It sounds weird because Mercury is so close to the Sun and gets extremely hot, but these permanently shadowed spots don't get any sunlight and they stay frozen. Finding ice, there was a breakthrough because it suggests that other volatile substances, like possibly organic compounds, might also be found there. So how do we study such a hard-to-reach place? Well, getting to Mercury is quite challenging due to its close position to the Sun and its fast orbit. Space missions to Mercury need to do a lot of careful planning and use complex paths to get there. They often fly by other planets like Venus to help slow down and adjust their trajectory to eventually get into orbit around Mercury. One of the missions on its way to explore Mercury is called BepiColombo. Launched in 2018, BepiColombo is using the gravity of other planets to help it reach and enter Mercury's orbit by 2025, after flying by planets multiple times. Once it gets there, BepiColombo has another challenge. Mercury's days are scorching hot, and its nights are freezing cold due to its slow rotation. The spacecraft will have to manage these extreme temperatures to keep working. This is crucial not just for gathering data, but also for the survival of the spacecraft. Our understanding of Mercury and its rotation has also evolved with new research. Recent computer models suggest that Mercury used to spin much faster. However, it slowed down over time due to the effects of the sun's gravity, and possibly because of collisions with large objects like asteroids or comets. These studies are important because they help us understand not just Mercury, but also offer insights into how planets change over time. They raise new questions too, like how does Mercury's core stay liquid? How does its unique spin and orbit affect its geological features? As we keep studying Mercury, we uncover more and more about this little planet. It might be small, but Mercury is a key to understanding many fundamental questions about our solar system. Scientists used to think it was just a simple ball of rock close to the sun, but now we know it's much more than that. We've learned that Mercury's core is unusually large for its size. About 85% of Mercury is its core, while Earth's core makes up only about 15% of its volume. This suggests that Mercury might have had a rough past, possibly involving a massive impact that stripped away much of its outer material, leaving behind a large, metal-rich core. This core is the reason why Mercury has a magnetic field. The field is about 1% as strong as Earth's and is surprisingly offset from the center, which could be due to the uneven distribution of materials in its crust. This was another unexpected discovery that came from studying the planet's magnetic field in more detail. Moreover, in 2020, researchers found substances on Mercury like sulfur, potassium, and sodium that usually evaporate quickly at high temperatures. This was a surprising find on such a hot planet and suggests these elements might have been brought to Mercury by comets or asteroids after the planet had formed. Another intriguing discovery was water ice in the permanently shadowed craters near Mercury's poles. The existence of ice and potentially organic compounds in such a harsh environment makes us wonder about the possibilities of life's building blocks being present on other planets. Each new discovery about Mercury opens up possibilities and leads to more questions. It's a reminder that even the smallest member of our solar system has a lot of lessons to teach us about the universe. Could Mercury hold more clues about the early solar system? What else might we find hidden in its craters or buried in its history? These ongoing explorations are what keep the study of planets so exciting and full of surprises. Mercury, a planet often overlooked, is stirring up a lot of interest with its surprising geological activities. Most people thought Mercury was a quiet, unchanging rock floating near the sun. But recent missions, especially data from MESSENGER, have shown that Mercury is still buzzing with geological activities that we're only starting to understand. Dr. David Rothery from the Open University in the UK spotted small, shiny areas on Mercury's surface that look like volcanic openings. These spots, known as hollows, are pretty exciting because they suggest that Mercury isn't as dormant as we once thought. It might still have geological processes going on right now. After exploring Mercury's icy regions, we now face a messy landscape that hints at its rough past. The chaotic lands of Mercury. One of the more confusing parts of Mercury is its chaotic terrain, a huge mess of mixed up hills and valleys around the planet's south pole. It's about the size of Texas and was first seen by the Mariner 10 spacecraft back in the 70s. Dr. Thomas Waters from the Smithsonian Institution thinks this jumbled area might have come from big earthquakes. These quakes could have been caused by the strong pull of the sun as Mercury's orbit changed over time. Dr. Amir Khan and his team at the University of Zurich have dug deep into what Mercury is made of, thanks to MESSENGER. They found out that, like Earth, Mercury has a core with a liquid outer part and a solid center. But here's where it gets interesting. Mercury's solid center is way bigger in proportion than Earth's, which might help explain some of Mercury's unusual magnetic qualities. These discoveries keep changing our views on how planets form and change, showing us that even our neighboring planets can still surprise us. Researchers keep finding more about Mercury's hidden layers. Unlike Earth, which has a solid ball inside surrounded by liquid metal, most of Mercury's core is liquid with a solid bit in the middle. This was confirmed by the Messenger mission, which noticed tiny changes in how Mercury pulls gravitationally, helping map out its inside structure. Mercury's inner solid core is huge, spanning about 1,260 miles wide, making up almost half of its total core. This is way bigger compared to Earth's core, which only makes up about 20% of our planet's core volume. The size and makeup of Mercury's core are crucial for its magnetic field, which, though weaker than Earth's, is still pretty strong for such a small planet. Underneath its surface, Mercury has a mantle that's thinner than we thought before, only about 260 miles thick. This is much thinner compared to Earth's mantle, which is about 1,800 miles thick. This thin mantle affects how heat moves around inside Mercury and its geological activity. One of the coolest findings from 2012 by Messenger was signs of old volcanic activity. The spacecraft spotted unusual shallow pits called hollows, which probably formed when some volatile materials from Mercury's inside turned into gas and escaped. This hints that Mercury once had more of these volatile materials than we used to think. In 2010, a new major discovery was made using Messenger's data. Scientists found signs of a huge ancient magma ocean beneath Mercury's surface, which must have played a big part in shaping Mercury's surface and inside structure. This old magma sea could be why there are big, smooth plains covering a lot of Mercury's northern half, probably from massive lava flows back in Mercury's early days. The most mind-blowing discovery about what's under Mercury's surface came in 2022. Researchers looking at Messenger data found hints of nitrogen trapped under Mercury's surface. This could mean that Mercury might have had a thicker atmosphere long ago that got pushed underground by the strong heat and sunlight hitting the planet. This raises some exciting possibilities about what Mercury's atmosphere might have been like long ago, and if it could have been a place that supported life at some point. Moreover, there's ice made of water in the shadows of craters at Mercury's poles. This ice is hidden from direct sunlight and kept frozen by the deep cold in these shadowed spots. Recent studies think some of this ice is pretty new, maybe dropped off by comets or asteroids not too long ago. These same craters might also hold dark stuff that could be organic compounds, maybe left over from comets or asteroids that hit Mercury. Keeping these organic bits intact gives us a rare chance to learn about how organic materials are spread around the closer parts of our solar system. Could Mercury be just another rocky planet, or is there something far more shocking hidden beneath its surface that NASA doesn't want us to know? Is it possible that this tiny world holds clues about our universe's darkest things? Tell us what you think in the comments, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more.